find a transportation cost, it means that you need to go for both the methods, both the phases. If they ask only the find IBFS by particular method, then you can go for the only that IBFS. Find transportation cost, in a sense, it includes both the phases. In this, if they are not mentioned the any method, either NWCM, LCM or VAM, you can go for any method, but I suggest that better to go for VAM. Okay, now I'll explain about the how we can go for the IV, that okay, optimization of transportation problem by Modi method. And this phase will start after the IBFS. Okay. Now we'll start with optimization of transportation problem by modified distribution method. In this, so there are many, so three steps we need to follow. Step one is we need to check, is the IBFS matrix having the M plus N minus 1 that should be equal to number of allocations. What do you mean by M plus N minus 1? M and N are nothing but the order of the matrix. If the in the any one matrix, if there is a three rows, that is a three cross, and if there are four columns, then it's a three cross four matrix, order of the matrix. If three is the M and four is the N. Now M plus N, 3 plus of 4 plus of 1 plus minus of 1, that should be equal to number of allocations. Number of allocation in the sense, so previously we have allocated some numbers. So that numbers you need to count. If it is equal, so okay, 3 plus 4 minus 1 is 6. If the number of allocations are also 6, then we can proceed. If it is not equal, then we cannot proceed. And we can name that problem as that belongs to the degeneracy transportation problem. Then we need to make that equal and then proceed. Now I am explaining the problem, which is equal, M plus N minus 1 is equal to number of allocation. Okay, now we'll say that it is equal. Step number two is find UIs and VJs. Find UIs and VJs for the allocated cell. Find UIs and VJs for allocated cells. And the step number three is find delta ij. Delta ij, the formula is Cij minus of UI plus VJ for unallocated cell. Try to understand where is the allocated and where is the unallocated. Step number two is belongs to the allocated cell, as the step number three belongs to the unallocated cell. And after completion of the step number three, if all the delta ij are greater than or equal to zero, then the solution is optimum. If any one value is lesser than zero, I mean negative values, then we need to shift the allocation to the other cell and repeat all the steps. How to shift that allocations? By drawing the horizontal and vertical line. So wherever there is a allocation, then we can take the left or right or the up or down turn. So that should be a closed loop. At the end, that should be a closed loop. Okay, if there are two negative values like minus 2 and minus 3, then minus 3 is the most negative value. So from which cell you got the minus 3, from that you need to start drawing the line. That is the other case. Okay, if in the third stage, if all the delta ij are 0, then we can say that a given solution is, so that is the optimum. Okay, here, so already we have solved one problem. So I have taken it from the IBFS. So already there we have finished with the IBFS, and these are all the allocations. Okay, in this we can, what is the first step? Check M plus N minus 1 equal to number of allocations. What is the M plus N now? So 3 by 4 is a matrix. So 3 plus 4 plus minus of 1, that is the equal to 6. And what is the number of allocations? So number of allocations are also 6. If it is equal, then we can proceed. Okay, what is the second stage? Second step is to find UIs and VJs. Find UIs and VJs for allocated cell. Find UIs and VJs for allocated cell. So how to find the UIs and VJs for allocated? You can see here. Okay, first we need to add this first row. Okay, first we need to add this equation for allocated cell. So these equations we need to add. How to add this one? So before writing this equation, so we need to add the u1 equal to first row, u1, u2 and u3 for the third row. For the column wise, v1, v2, v3 and v4 for the column wise. After writing this one, the step itself says that for allocated cell. So which is the allocated cell? The first one, u1, v1 is the allocated cell. For this, the formula is ui plus of vj, ui plus of vj is equal to cij. Ui plus of vj that equal to the cij. So for the first cell, u1 plus of v1 equal to 11. Likewise, we need to create the equation. u1 plus of v1 is equal to u1 plus of v1 is equal to 11. And for the second cell, for this cell, we can say that u1 plus of v2 equal to 13. And for this one, we can say that u2 plus of v2 equal to 18. And for this one, u3 plus v3. Okay, here it is. And for this one, u2 plus of v4 equal to 10. Now, last one, u3 plus of v4 equal to 10. So likewise, we need to add the equation. Okay, now we need to find the answer, that all the UIs and VJs. Okay, here we need to fix anyone as a zero. Anyone as a zero, but here I have taken it as a U1. Okay, while taking the anyone as a zero, we need to consider which row or the column having more number of allocations. So which row or the column having the more number of allocations? So here if you check that one, all the three rows, the first row, second row, third row having the two allocations each, and even the column wise also second and fourth column having the two allocations. So it means that either you can give U1, U2, U3 or V2 or V4. So anyone equal to zero, because all the five are having the two numbers of allocations. Okay, now I'll go with the U1. Okay, if you give the U1 equal to 0, then if it is 0, then what is the answer? V1 equal to 11. Okay, I got the answer V1 equal to 11. Next one, again, the U1 is 0, then V2 equal to 13. Because already we have written the equation, so just put those values here. Next one, U2 plus of V2. Already we know the value of U2. So just put it here, U2 value, then you will get the V2 value. V2 is 13. If you put the V2 equal to 13, then U2 is a 5. So likewise, we need to find all the UIs and VJs. See, there is one more technique to find the UIs and VJs. Okay, anyhow, you can write the equations. You can write the equations, or else if you don't want to write the equations, so then sometimes there is a chance of missing the marks also. Better write the equations and confirm the answers. Before that, what we are supposed to do? Okay, now I have considered the U1 as a 0. Okay, I will write the U1 as 0. Okay, for the first cell, for the 11, what is the equation actually? U1 plus of V1. Okay, for this V1, the equation will be 11 minus of 0. What is the 11 minus of 0? 11 minus of 0 is 11. That directly we can write. So it is the same one. So here I have written the equation. So U1 plus of V1 is equal to C11. What is the U1 value? U1 is 0. What about the V1? V1 I don't know. C11 is 11. Then V1 equal to 11 directly. So directly also we can write it. This will be 11. Okay, now I know the V1 value. After that, okay, for the second cell, for this U1 is 0, then V2 equal to 13 minus of 0, that is 13. Okay, now I know. Okay, for this 18, 18 minus of 13 is 5. 18 minus of 13 is 5. Next one, this one. 10 minus of 5 is 5. 10 minus of 5 is 5. Okay, now this one. 10 minus of 5 is 5. I hope you are following me. Next one, 13 minus of, for this one, 13 minus of 5 is 8. Okay, now we can check the answers also. So I got the same answers there. U2, V4, U3 and V3. This is the way also you can find the UIs and VJs. Okay, once we finish with finding the UIs and VJs for allocated cell, then we need to proceed to the step number 3, that is finding the delta IJ for unallocated cell. So this is the delta IJ for unallocated cell. Okay, I have written all the that UIs and VJs in the font, red color font. After that, for unallocated cell, what is the equation for unallocated cell? Delta IJ equal to CIJ minus of UI plus VJ. CIJ minus of VI plus IJ. What is that CIJ? CIJ are nothing but the transportation cost. IJ is nothing but that, so which place it is. For the delta 1-3, okay, this is the delta 1-3. For this, CIJ is 17. CIJ is 17. What is the UI and VJ? 0 and 8. Okay, this is a 9. Likewise, for unallocated cells, we need to write the equation for delta 1-4. 1-4 is a first row, fourth column. Second row, first column. Second row, third column. Third row, first column. Third row, and second column at the last one. So likewise, for each unallocated cells, we need to write the delta IJ. We need to find the answer. Okay, now we can say that all these delta IJ values are positive. Hence, all the delta IJ are greater than or equal to 0. Therefore, whatever the allocations you have done in the previous step, that is IBFS, that is the final answer. We have reached the optimum stage. After that, you need to find the transportation cost by multiplying the cost and number of allocations you have done. If all the delta IJ are not greater than or equal to 0, then we need to proceed to draw the closed loop by drawing the horizontal and vertical line. And next, we need to take the turn wherever the allocation is there. That is the different problem. This is the way we need to find the optimum solution by MODI method.